Wales. So ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Kuli Comet.
She knocked me down. I was her supple light dog. I did not climb nor found. I twisted, crumpled, folded, dragged about in and out. I choked in silence. I was folded, seamless, floored, and lagged. No sign of core damage. I was robust. If I'd been made of porcelain, she would have turned me to dust. Unheard. What happened in that? I'm partially deaf and I've never liked wearing hearing aids. And when I last year my boss said you have to go and get your hearing sorted out. Yeah. So this is about hearing aids. Introduction to a noisy world inspired by hearing aids. Beneath crunching gravel and rocks, dribbling drips of water tinkle, the annoying ticking of the clock, disturbing crisp packets crinkle. Garden birds sing jubilant songs, falling raindrops tap down the pitter, whispering breeze gossiping throng, autumn leaves blankets of litter. Our tiptoes as we sleep indoors, my heart's rhythmic beat, something beat, footsteps clobber on creaky floors. I hear with ace murmurs discreet. Your speech like jewels, sound travels quick, my finger type words click to click.
Yeah, that's cool. Can I just say that I, without wishing to embarrass Kuli in any way, that when she arrived today, she wanted me to read her poetry. And we did our workshop, and we all said, no, read it yourself. And obviously we're just lazy geeks, but... But seriously, I want everyone to show their appreciation and say to Kuli, never ask anyone else to read your poetry because it is awesome as you present it.
Yeah.